Hey guys, welcome to Indie Game Hustle. In this UModeler video, we're going to take a look at our drawing tools. So the first thing we're going to do is go ahead and click on our new UModeler tool here. And we're going to get that UModeler object here so that we have our little icon or our little square here so we can draw in the scene. And what we're going to do is head over to the side here and where it says drawing, the particular category called drawing. And in this category, we have a line tool, an arch tool, the rectangle tool, a disc tool, like a circle. We have a stair, and then we have this parallel tool. All right, so to demonstrate these tools, what I'm going to do is draw them out on a mesh. So what I'm going to do is use the box tool, and I'm going to draw out a rectangle or a cube here so that we can see these tools fully. All right. So now that we have these tools, what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate this so we can get a clearer view. All right, great. So the first tool we want to take a look at is the line tool. And the line tool is pretty much what you expect. It allows you to draw on any particular surface of a mesh. And if I was to click, now we can actually draw this line in any direction we need to. And as you can see, I can draw and continue drawing until I'm ready to complete this drawing. Now I can draw all the way up to this point, and as you notice, it's clicking or snapping to this point. Even though I don't have snapping turned on, it's recognizing that it's within this line here, so we can line it up. And so I'm just gonna click off of that. Sorry about that. Let me go ahead and click back. And as you can see, if I click and then boom, and so we've closed that completely. And I'll hit the escape key to get off of that. And so now we have this line tool. Now we can manipulate this even still by selecting these vertices, by going into your vertice tool and selecting these vertices and doing whatever you need to do. So if you want to make that do something like this, you can do that, which is great. So that's the line tool. Now the line tool can also be used not on a mesh, but it can also be used, I believe, on anywhere here. So if we were to click and drag just like so, and if you want to connect it, it creates a face, as you can see. Let me click that back. Boom. So I hit enter, or I hit confirm, and there we go. Now we have a tool like that. And so this is pretty useful too, because what you can do, if I were to get rid of these and I go back and just create something here, what I could do is go here, do something like this, and I'm just kind of creating just whatever I feel like making, some type of shape here. And as you can see, I'm going to complete that and I'll just confirm it. And so we now have this shape. Now the shape isn't completely useful. However, I can go to my face tool, and if I hold down the shift key and zoom, go up, now we have something that could resemble maybe a building, maybe, I don't know. Now, of course, we're not inside that building because of this, but you know, there's a feature where you can actually flip the normals. And we'll take a look at that tool specifically in another video, but you can actually flip the normals here. And I believe it is in one of these areas. I think it's right here, flip tool. And we can actually flip that. Now, what you want to do is select the whole thing and flip it. And so now we have all of that flipped like so. So that's a pretty useful tool. I'll go ahead and delete that. All right, so let's go back to our box tool and take a look at our other ones. So I'm going to create this box and let's look at the arch tool. Now I love the arch tool as well. What this one is, you click and then you hold it down. And then once you let go, you can actually create this arch like this. And then your next click is gonna be the confirmation, right? So what we can do is do something like this, click. And so now we have that arch tool and we're good to go there. Now you can continue to make more arches if you want, or you can go into an edit tool, edit vertices or the line tool, that sort of thing, or faces if needed. But then once you're in object mode, you won't be able to see that line there. And you can combine this with the other tools. So for instance, if we were to say, now grab the line tool and we can kind of do more stuff. So we can say, oh, I want to create some type of doorway or something. Now I probably wouldn't create a doorway this way. Personally, there's probably a couple other ways I would do this, but this is just one perspective. You can start finding out different ways you can use these tools together. I'm just going to go ahead and confirm that and delete this completely. All right, so the another tool that we can use will be the rectangle tool. And what I'll do is take this and create. Now, this is a really big cube here, and I probably want to make this a little smaller. I'll just bring it down. Actually, I want to select behind that. So I'll go down and bring this a little smaller like so. All right, and then I'll go ahead and select this rectangle tool. And what I want to do is create a rectangle. So we can do something like this. And as you can see, I got that rectangle tool. And again, combining these tools together, now we can maybe do something like this. So if I click and drag, and so now we have something like that, right? That's pretty nice. And so now we have these two faces here. And we can do whatever we want at this point. We can create like an inset or whatever, right? So that's pretty cool use of those particular line tools, which is part of our drawing category. Now, another tool we have here is the circle tool, or disk tool is what it's called. And so we can select this disk tool and we can create a disk or a circle shape here, and that's pretty cool. And so I think we can change the segments after. Yeah, so you can change the segments if you want to make it really high, and this is basically going to control the vertice count, right? So 25, that looks about round to me. And so if we confirm it, we're good to go. So now we actually have that, and you want to see the verts that it creates. There you have it. So that's pretty cool. So again, there's lots of tools here, and your creativity will help drive, you know, what you make and everything. And so, as you can see, I can just kind of bevel, or not bevel, but extrude this in, or you can extrude it out, whatever you want to do. But that is the disk line tool, which is really cool. I really like that too, as well. Now, another option we have here is this stairs here. Now I'll go on the other side of this mesh just to demonstrate this particular one. So I'm going to select this and I'm going to click and drag. And as you can see, I'm kind of creating this line shape, kind of like our stairs in terms of our primitive shapes, but instead it's just a line tool here. And so once I click off to that, we can create and minimize the level of stairway that is displayed there. So that's kind of neat. And if you find out that's about what you're looking for, maybe you want to go with like a 0.25, something, I don't know, just depends on what you're looking for. Say that's good. And then you hit confirm. Now you have an actual face in the shape of those stairs, right? Now, of course, say for instance, this was the side of a wall and we wanted some stairs there. Yep, you can create something like that. And again, there's multiple ways to approach a project like this, but you could do very well this and create some stairs directly off of a mesh, or you can use the stairs primitive and put it in place as well. So it's kind of the choice is yours, but it's all about understanding and knowing what the tools do and that sort of thing. All right, so I'll leave that there. Another thing you can play with is the next tool, and our last tool is the parallel tool. So what I'll do is select the parallel tool. Now what this tool, I don't use this tool very often, but for instance, if I click this tool and click on a face, what it does is it's gonna give us a line parallel to the line it's next to. So if I click here, there should be a line right there, and if I click next to it, it's going to keep doing that. And so if I do this line, it's going to be parallel to the one that it's closest to. if that makes any sense. So that can be useful for creating some additional things. Now, I think you can also increase the distance. So right now it's set to 0.1, but if I set it to 1, it makes it a little wider as opposed to smaller like that. Let's see if I do it here. Yeah, it's an interesting tool. I don't particularly use it, but I can definitely see it if you need to kind of break up some spaces and whatnot. So interesting tool there. Let me know in the comments if this is a tool that you guys would use at all. But for the most part, that is a good look at kind of the drawing tools, and it's up to you how you go about using them, but I think they're all very useful in different ways. All right, great. Well, I'll see you guys in the next video.